Okay. Oh shit. Oh shit.
But it's the eyeliner for me, really. It's the eyeliner that kind of freaks me out. And this was an
I am the happiest I've ever been.
Hello and welcome back, you beautiful nerds, to another edition of That's right, I'm this little corner of the internet, which is actually my bathroom. Hello, hi. Welcome. So by the way, Derek and everyone, this toilet is broken. I mean, it's not broken, it just keeps running. She just has a lot to say all the time. So there will be times where I'm gonna make an excellent point and it's gonna be punctuated by my toilet running. That's all right, currently it is 7 in the morning. I was up at 6:45. Because that is, my beautiful nerds, exactly 3 hours before I have to start work. And why am I doing this? Don't actually know. No, I do know. Because I am, that's right, a 33-year-old woman recreating a makeup look from Euphoria. By the way, there are spoilers to this video, but to be fair, I waited 2 weeks after the episode dropped to release this video, so. In case you missed it, in season 2, episode 3 of Euphoria, we see Cassie, who is one of our favorite characters, played by actress Sydney Sweeney, execute a wake-up morning routine, a get-ready with me, that is exactly 3 hours long. She starts it at 4 a.m., and she does all this in order to capture the attention of Nate What's-His-Face from the show. The guy. This scene is truly beguiling to me because it really takes me back to my morning routine in high school. In high school, I used to, get this, wake up at 5-ish a.m. in the morning, immediately stand out of bed, hit the floor, do 60-odd crunches, 50-11 push-ups, then I would hit the shower, I would listen to Hot Fuss, the Killers album, do my eyebrows, dress up in my cute little private school uniform, go downstairs, eat a healthy breakfast of 2 strips of turkey bacon and some grapes, and hurry up and catch my ride to school. Now, my high school routine wasn't as extreme as Sydney Sweeney's in Euphoria, nor is it as extreme as some other high school girls I know. While I may not have the finesse, the style, or the tits, God bless, of the high school students in Euphoria, I do remember the sense of urgency I used to feel to wake up and make myself perfect for a Trey, a Nate, or God forbid, a T-Bop. Yes, yes, yes. There was actually a kid at my high school who was actually the high school quarterback named T-Bop. As a 33-year-old woman, I had the wisdom or the dating history to know that losing precious sleep over a boy who has a hyphen in his name is not a good look. Just to recap, sleep is a literal reset for the human brain, you know, just like wait up. But you know, it's biology, you know, like it's hard no matter what your age is to not get manic over getting your crush's attention despite whether or not they have a hyphen in their name. But what was fascinating to me was in the aftermath of the episode dropping, we saw a lot of articles crop up and go viral, like this one, how to replicate Cassie's 4 a.m. routine. Or this one, Cassie's helpless, Nate's the predator. Or this one, how much Cassie's 4 a.m. routine costs. Or a dermatologist reacts to Cassie's 4 a.m. skincare routine. I feel like we've missed the point. I feel like we may be missing the point. And I've already deemed 2022 the year of the goddess. It's official. And this year we were unpacking together all of the things in the cultural zeitgeist that are deemed as feminine. So this morning, we're recreating this routine, performed by arguably the most overtly feminine character in the show. And we're gonna attempt a makeup look, all before my 9 a.m. work call, so we can really understand the message of this scene.
Cassie's self-care scene was probably my favorite part of all last episode, but she used one tool that really surprised me. This one right here. So this is basically a tiny little vibrating gold bar. And if you've ever gotten your lips done or seen any videos of lip injections, you might have seen it used. And since I'm an aesthetic nurse and I used to do injections, I thought it'd be fun to explain why. So there is something called vibration anesthesia. The gist of it is our brain can only handle so much stimuli. So when we're experiencing something painful, like getting our lips done, if there is something vibrating or tapping, it almost distracts our brain and makes it less painful. It's pretty cool, and there's actually some studies that have have shown, yes, it does really decrease pain. So I'm not really sure why Cassie was using it on her face, maybe just for circulation, blood flow purposes, but if you're getting your lips done, this can be a really helpful tool.
So I'm gonna be upfront with y'all at the top. We don't really have all of Cassie's equipment to her 4 a.m. routine. In fact, you can click on any of those articles, I'll link them below, and find out that Cassie's morning routine costs around like $400 to $600, depending on which news outlet you're relying on. So like, I'm not about to go out and spend $600 right now. But I do have this thing. This is a high frequency, zapper. I got this from my mom. Backstory context. My mom has had some health issues in the past year, and a lot of her health issues have affected her face. When any kind of surgery affects your face or whatnot, it's hard to kind of feel that factor. So I bought her one of these machines in order to kind of like give her a sense of control. Oh no, in order to work this machine, I gotta unplug my cutesy lights. All right, let's see. Holy shit. I have no idea if this is effective at all. It's just kind of like, if you're a peasant like me, sometimes you do this. Sometimes you throw caution to the wind and purchase a beauty tool in the slight, slight chance that it may cure your ugly. You know, we are all just one beauty treatment away from being beautiful. Or at least that's what the voice in my head tells me. I feel like that's why Cassie, a literal high school student, may feel compelled to use a beauty routine like this one. Because in her mind, that may be the thing that makes her perfect. In that Euphoria scene, Cassie also has her hair in some kind of like sleep rollers. I don't have that, but I did sleep in braids last night to give me that natural wave. By the way, I love to primp. I am a primpy girl. I love the ritual, I love the touch, I love feeling like a queen as I rub oils that promise me the world into my skin. So I do not say any of this about Cassie's routine or any kind of routine like this with a shred of judgment. I have no judgment. Oh, there she is. So I usually don't watch a lot of high school shows, just because in high school, it doesn't really resonate with me. In high school, my parents were very strict. Like, all these parents that are like, yes, go out, get home by, you know, 11, maybe. That was not my parents. I didn't have a car, I didn't have a cell phone. And a lot of times, because my parents were so strict, I didn't have a lot of privacy. I didn't have a lot of me time. Bathroom time, primping time for me in high school was a lot of times the only time I would have any privacy. I kind of really understand the scene. Is it doing it? Is it making me beautiful? Look at, oh shit, oh shit. What? Let's just show the TikTok.
Foundation plays a major role in Euphoria this season. Director Sam Levinson banned foundation on set with one exception, Maddy, whose look involves a full face. But Donnie Davies says one other character will be trying harder with their makeup this season, and you'll see them in foundation. And I think we all know who that is.
I have to say that I stan each and every makeup look in Euphoria so hard. All the looks are inventive. All of the looks are glittery. They're maximal. I love Jules' looks. Rue doesn't really do a lot of makeup, but I love her looks. I love them all. Which is why I was shocked when I learned that not many characters in the show wear foundation. Then I remembered these are actors and they're beautiful. I am going to attempt a makeup look today. Specifically, this Dolly Parton Oklahoma look. But I am so worried that I am going to feel old in my attempt to do anything. I used to be one of those girls who was like, what's the point in primer? Like, why are we spending more money on stuff? And then, you know, I started getting my first little bits of wrinkles. And now I get it. Ooh, now I get why primer. You know, I never, believe it or not, I didn't do my makeup at home in high school. Partly because I didn't want my mom hovering. I didn't want her to like looking and watching and asking questions. I just wanted her to buy me things. So unfair. Teenage girls are brutal. Like, literally brutal. So what I would do is I would pack all of my makeup in this huge freaking bag, like a Vera Wang bag, God bless, and I would take it to high school and file into the girls' bathroom where like 80% of the girls in my graduating class would be like crowded around a mirror putting on their makeup. That was a whole thing. Catch me in the girls' bathroom with everyone else just attempting to put on our makeup. We had our bronzer sticks. Do you remember those bad boys that you'd click, 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 and we didn't know the term contour. You were a bad bitch back then if you had Clinique
Okay.
I feel like everyone who watches Euphoria, who, you know, is a millennial internet culture writer, there is a rush to blame in this scene where Cassie is putting on her makeup and, you know, doing her get ready with me. There's a rush to point out her mania. There's a rush to point out the fact that she's losing it, which, you know, I'm not about to argue with. Because, as my good friend Fred has once said, Cassie does love to shed a tear. This is high school, babes. Who has it?
It's already because I have work soon creeping up. I can tell you with great confidence that my makeup is not gonna be as well done as Cassie's. But a bitch can try. So I've also been seeing a lot of TikToks recently, a lot of fan theory TikToks, where people compare Cassie to Maddy. And in doing so, they pit these women against each other, right?
But isn't that what we do to women all the time? We have the sinner, we have the saint.
And I feel like Euphoria is setting us up to do just that. And they do that in the makeup.
It feels like every costume choice, every makeup look is intentional. And with Cassie's like soft country western look, it's giving me very much like a Taylor Swift meets Dolly Parton kind of spectrum-y look. Whereas Maddy has got her bad bitch eyeliner, sharp angles, wham bam, thank you ma'am. There's been so much chatter online of people talking about how weak Maddy is and how she's like headed for a mental breakdown, a tiny menti bee, which like, fine, yes. But I take issue with this like calling her weak. A, because ostensibly her character's in high school. This is the training ground in which we learn these lessons, y'all. And B, I think it highlights the very argument that a lot of these articles are trying to point out. Like, Gen Z is the generation that grows up so fast. They're here to save the world. They're growing up so fast. But they're still literal kids, right? They're still young. Despite their like gorgeous looks and well coiffed hair and the ability to wield a makeup brush as if it was like a weapon. So I just kind of, it really irks me whenever I log on to twitter.com and see people being like, Cassie's the weakest person in the show. Cringe. Cringe. One thing I do love about makeup, and one thing I do think that this generation does get right, is that makeup is a powerful tool. Makeup doubles as a costume and armor. Like, it's so freaking powerful. Especially for people who believe that their power solely lies in how they look. Which, I feel like this routine that Cassie enacts every morning in the show is an attempt to take back power. To take back control. Even in the script, the voiceover bits, Rue talks about how Cassie enjoys her wake up morning routine because it makes her, she likes the time to clear her head. And certainly that resonates with me because in high school, you know, I didn't have any control. I would try to control the way I would look, the way my makeup would sit, the way my uniform would look on me, how skinny I was, etc., etc. I would try to control the way I looked in order to feel like I had some control over my circumstance. And I certainly feel like that's what Cassie is doing. Time check, I have less than an hour before I have to be on a work call. I feel like all my coworkers, when they should see me, are gonna be like, are you well? If I'm wearing makeup, I feel like my coworkers are gonna be like, who died?
All right, babe, we're about to go in with the liquid liner. Okay, you can do this. Right, you've got a steady hand, multiple degrees from credible universities. You can do it.
I decided, I made an executive decision to skip the lashes because I am simply running out of time.
Let's talk about why Cassie is always wearing either blue or pink. The costume designer says that Cassie has a very traditional view of what is considered feminine. She tends to lean on tropes that she considers to be beautiful. More than any of the characters, her clothes are a costume, and the way she dresses is about wanting to be loved.
Going back in with a little beat for extra measure. I feel like the trope of showing a character, specifically a female character's emotional state through showing her get ready with me is a popular one in modern television. Like take this scene from Miss Maisel where she wakes up early so her husband can never have to deal with her morning breath. God bless. I'm pretty sure my grandmother used to do that exact same thing. These kind of scenes say a lot about what society expects from these female characters and how they react to that expectation. However, when we teach young girls and show them Disney movies about Prince Charming's going to scoop them up if they wear the right shoes, who's to blame? Who's to blame when we put so much emphasis on how we look from a young age? Of course
a character like Cassie and other girls like her would put so much emphasis on how they look. Cassie is on her way to having a little menti bee in the show. She is. But who hasn't experienced a little menti bee? I mean, Maddy, her character foil, the bad bitch, remember? She had a little mental bee in season one. Many of them. And everyone still sees her as a bad bitch.
I've been having some thoughts. We tend to associate rage as like a divine masculine energy, but what if there is a specific feminine rage? And what if the reason it tends to be repressed is because it is very, very scary? So quick spark notes, divine masculine, divine feminine. I think of it almost like exhale, inhale. Divine masculine is energy that's about doing rather than being. It's sending out the energy. It gets external. Divine feminine is internal, receiving, being. So possibly by that logic, masculine rage is like a fire intended to burn outward. And feminine rage is what happens when we receive all of the wrongs and the cruelties and the things that are just not right about the world and what that does to a human. And when those floodgates are open, you don't stop until you burn it all down. It's beautiful, it's necessary, and it's dark.
I am not dressing up like a Euphoria character because I'm going to my computer. And actually, I had the thought, like, I should, because I have this client call today where we're gonna be talking to the executives for the show that I'm producing. And I had the thought, ooh, maybe I should wash my face before that call. Like, I literally had the thought, like, I don't want them to think that they can't respect me anymore. And how stupid is that? It's wild that I had this thought, like, I want them to still think of me as the co-executive producer that I am. Wow. We just tapped into some deep shit, didn't we? I want to leave you with this thought. What if Cassie's experiencing a deep kind of feminine rage? Internal instead of external. Internal and destructive. Driven by a lack of what is supposed to be life's most natural resource. Love. What if the symptoms of this internal deep feminine rage is more emotive and driven by mania and tears? But it's still rage. Right? Have you been there before? Because I know I have. What do you think about this scene in Euphoria? What do you think about Cassie as a character in Euphoria? Tell me in the comments below and let me know. And wish me luck because I'm gonna be Cassie for the rest of the day. Here we go.